Shit is wild, man. I'm with my girl. I travel everywhere with my girl, which is stupid. I bring my girl everywhere because I love her, but also, ugh, fuck her. You know, it's annoying. Like, I'm in love. I'm in love. This is a woman I've chased. I'm in love. I've chased this woman for years, but also, like, ugh, shut the fuck up and go away. Like, we shouldn't be taking trips together. I realize that. That's where I'm fucking up. We should be going on trips, but we should go on our separate trips. Like, she goes to Hawaii, I go to London, and we switch. You know what I mean? I go to Hawaii, she goes to London, so we see the same shit, so we could talk about it later. We got a dialogue, but we don't actually have to be in the same fucking space, because that seems to be creating the problems. Like, recently I went home, I went back to Boston, because that's where I'm from. I'm a Boston kid, you know? But I also don't go back often because my whole family's there. Like, all of them. And I love them, but it's a lot. You know what I mean? So I try to avoid the place. But I was like, nah, my girl needs to meet my people. I'm going fucking home. I take my girl. I go back home. It was nice at first. She met my favorite uncle. He's my favorite uncle because every time I see him, he asks me if I'm still gay, which is nice. Every time I see him, he's like, hey, you still messing with the ladies? Like, one day I was like, nah, unk, back sucking these dicks. Back on these dicks, partner. That's what I'm... putting my mouth on balls again, baby. That's how I like to live. But it was dope. It was nice for my girl to just see where the fuck I come from, you know? You always want that with your partner. Just see how I grew up. See the people that raised me. Just get to know me a little bit better. And all of that felt really good. We was having a great time. I took her out. She met my friends from high school. A lot of my homegirls, like, you know, they were telling her stories about how I used to have my titties out and shit. You know, just letting her know who I used to be. And everything was chill. And everything was uncomfortable. It felt great. But then it got awkward because I bumped into the dude I lost my virginity to. And it was weird because we look the same now. Like, same outfit, same haircut. Like, what's up, nigga? What the fuck you? It's good with you, cuz. Fuck you on. I saw him before he saw me, and I was like, oh, shit, I sucked his dick. You know, like, I was, oh, my God. Because it's like, for a dyke, when you see old dicks you suck, they're like hauntings, you know? It's just like, remember, you used to do this. Like, oh, my God. Please don't come this fucking way. So I was like, oh, my God, I sucked his dick. What is he going to do? But he seen me at first. He was cool. He just gave me the, you know, you sucked my dick, head nod, kept it moving. He's like, you know what you did. I know, I know, I know, I know. Weird, though. Weird to be around my girl trying to be the best man I'm going to be and then seeing a dick I suck. I was like, I don't like this at all. Then he said the dumbest thing to me. We're standing across from each other, and he went, I just need to say this. I just hope I'm not the reason you're like this. Like, nigga, what? You think your 15-year-old dick swayed me in any direction? We were fucking kids, man. We could have been humping mattresses, you know? Hell no. Just sometimes people be gay and don't know it. It's possible.